If you are looking to remove pages from search engines, you are in the right place. Whether you are dealing with outdated information, sensitive data, or SEO concerns, removing or de-indexing pages ensures your online presence stays relevant and secure. So we're going to share with you a couple of ways to do it. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one tool that brings you easy-to-use SEO and AI tools, and this channel provides you with tips, tricks, and tutorials to grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, subscribe. Now, before we even start removing pages from search engines, we gotta know if it is first indexed, right? I'm gonna share with you two ways to know if a page is indexed. First is the site colon method. Simply go to Google and type in site colon and add the URL. As you hit enter or return, if you see search results here, it means that the page is indexed. But if you see something like this, it means the URL is not indexed. However, this is not the most accurate method, because if a URL is canonicalized or redirected, it will still show up in the site colon search. For example, bufferapp.com has been rebranded as just Buffer. And as I try to visit bufferapp.com, it will be redirected to just buffer.com. However, if we were to do a site colon search on one of Buffer App's link, we will see a search result showing that the page is indexed. But if you try to visit that page, you will realize that you are visiting the new domain address. So the site colon method is useful if you know that your pages are not redirected or canonicalized. The next method is more accurate. Simply go to your Google Search Console and use the URL inspection tool. Place the URL here and hit enter or return. And if your page is indexed, you will see this. And if your page is not indexed, you will see this instead. So the URL inspection tool is more accurate than the site colon method. All right, once you know that your page is indexed, there are a couple of ways you can remove it from the search engines. Now, if the page has sensitive information and needs to be removed from the search engines quickly, then using the Google Search Console's removal tool is the best option. But take note that this is a temporary removal for 6 months, and if you want to keep it permanent, you need to couple this method with others like the no-index meta tag method or deleting the content from your site. We'll talk about them in a while. For now, let's talk about the URL removal tool from your Search Console. Under the indexing category, you will find the removal tool here. Click on it, and right here you can request for a new removal. Now you will add the URL you wish Google to remove here. If it is just this URL you wish to remove, you can select this. But if it is a group of pages with the same prefix, for example, you want all the URLs in the same category like this to be removed, you will select this option instead. But that's not what we want. We just want to remove this URL. Click next. And as you can see here, this will only block the URL for about 6 months. Let's submit the request. And you are done. Now, this doesn't immediately guarantee that your page will be removed completely. Some instances, such as your page title and URL, may still appear in the results for related search queries. So as I said, you need follow-up actions if you want to remove the page completely. Now, if you think you have made a mistake and this URL should not be blocked, don't worry, you can just reverse it by clicking on this and cancel the request. And you are safe. Now, I'm pretty sure your pages will still be found on other search engines like Bing. So if you have access to the webmaster tools of those search engines, like for example, Bing Webmaster Tools, under the configuration tab, you will see the block URLs tool. This works similarly to the tool from Google Search Console. Just click on add URL to block. This tool will block the URL for 90 days. Similarly, you can select just a page or a directory. And if you select the cache only option, Bing will only block the cache page from showing up. This is great if you have sensitive information indexed and now you want to remove it. But if you want to block the page entirely, then you will select the URL and cache option and hit submit. All right, for the follow-up actions after the removal tool, you will want to consider this. Now, if you didn't use the removal tools from Google Search Console, Bing Webmaster Tools, or others, then simply using the robots.txt method can only prevent search engines from future crawling. Pages that are already crawled and indexed will still exist on the search engines. So if it is urgent to remove the page, then you will want to use the removal tools I've mentioned, coupled with this method. Let's say that you want to prevent this page from being crawled going forward. As a RankMath user, you can access the robots.txt file directly from your site. Hover over RankMath SEO, go to its general settings, and click on robots.txt. By default, RankMath will generate the rules for you. But if you decide to amend something, the default rules will be removed. So if you want to include the default rules before amending it, you will want to visit this page. This is the link. The same link is left in the description. Now you want to visit the RankMath's default robots.txt rule, copy this, go back to your site, and paste it here. Thereafter, under all user agents, which means all crawlers, which is represented by this, leave a space after the disallowed rule and add another disallowed rule. This is the URL I wish to block from crawling, but you can't have the full URL here. You want to delete the domain and leave just the URL slug, together with a forward slash at the start and at the end. If your URL has more than just the post name, for example, there is a category right in front, then you will add the path after your domain. If you have more than one page you wish to prevent from crawling, you can add another line of disallowed rule. And once you are done, save changes, and there we go. Now, if you do not have RankMath installed, then you will want to visit your cPanel and then to the file manager to find your robots.txt file and make changes from there. In case you want to dive deeper into understanding what the robots.txt file can do for you, feel free to check out this video right here. The link is in the description. Now, this method works, but normally for preventing specific pages from being indexed, you wouldn't use the robots.txt file. You would use this method instead. So search engines robots work this way. When they first visit your site, they will first check out the robots.txt file to read the rules of your site, and then they will start crawling the pages that they are allowed to. And then once they crawl a page and find a no index meta tag, it instructs the crawler not to index that specific page. This means that the page will not appear on a search engine results, even if it is crawled. We recommend using this method to prevent a page from being indexed because it gives you more control. There are two ways to do this. First is to add a line of code like this to the head section of your page source code. The second method is if you have RankMath installed on your site, simply visit the page you want to remove from the search engines, visit the RankMaths tab, and in the advanced options, you want to switch the robot's meta to no index. And remember to save changes. And if you want a page to be completely removed from existence, delete it from your site. This is the most extreme method, and coupling this with the removal tools from Search Console and Webmaster Tools, it will make sure that the page will never appear on the search engines forever. Simply visit your post list, and let's say that we want to remove this post completely. Hover over it and trash it. Once you have done that, when you visit the page URL again, you should see a 404 page or a 401 error. Now, sometimes deleted or trashed pages show the 404 status, but they return a 200 status code in the header. So for accuracy, you want to copy the URL of the deleted page, and we suggest that you use a tool like httpstatus.io to check the URL after deletion. If it returns a 404, that's good. But if it returns a 200 status code, then you would have to contact your web host or web developer to get it fixed. Now, if you do not want to delete the page completely, but you only want the administrators and editors to see it, then set it to private. So instead of deleting this page, visit it, and at the post settings, under the status, click on it and set it to private. Thereafter, save it. And that's it. So these are the methods to remove your pages from search engines if you own the website. But what happens if you do not own the website and you want certain content to be taken down? Now, if you do not own the website and you have no control over what should be taken down, then here are some things you can do. First is to contact the site owner and request that they remove the URL. Every website should have a contact us page and you should be able to reach out to them. But if there is no contact information, then you can leverage on Whois Lookup tools. Just search for Whois Lookup and there will be a couple of tools here. I recommend using the ICANN Lookup tool. For example, if you want to find the contact information of RankMath through this tool, just add the domain here and click on Lookup. In just a while, you'll be able to find the contact information of the domain. Now, if this option fails, then you should submit a legal removal request by visiting this page and submitting a request to Google. This is the link. We have left the same in the description. But before you submit a request, you will also want to go through Google's policies. Now, if you were successful every step of the way, the site owner confirmed that the page or image has been taken down from their end, but you still see the content in the Google search results, then you can visit this tool to submit a request to refresh outdated content. But before you do so, you should read this page to understand when you should or should not use this tool. And one more thing. If the content you wish to remove is not just on Google, maybe it is on Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest, or whatever, then check out this page. These are the links that will direct you to the right places to request for removal. I hope with this, whether you own a page or not, you will have clear steps to remove pages from the search engines. And if you have any questions at all, feel free to leave them in the comments down below. And don't forget to smash that thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, do so because we are all about helping you grow your search traffic. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.